Good morning, students. How are you all? Hope you're all fine at home. So, in today's class, we are going to continue the poem Teamwork. Okay? Teamwork. So, in the last class, we have seen only two stanza. We'll continue with the next one. And this poem was written by Jan Nigro. Okay? Jan Nigro. J-A-N-N-I-G-R-O. Jan Nigro. Okay. Now, let us read the poem from first. Teamwork, teamwork, together we can make our dream work. Then we'll share the joy of what we have done. Teamwork, everyone. It's fun to shoot the basketball to the hoop, but if nobody passes, then nobody shoots. And the relay race just can't go on if nobody wants to pass the baton. We are the parts that make up a whole, and we have got our eyes on a common goal. Sometimes it can be a big plus when a you or a me becomes an us. Okay, so I'll read the first stanza once again. Teamwork, teamwork, together we can make our dream work. Then we'll share the joy of what we have done. Teamwork, everyone. So what is the meaning of the first stanza here? Yes, the poet Jan Nigro asks us to work together as a team. Okay, so I have already told the definition of teamwork. So what is meant by teamwork? Yes, combined effort of group. Okay, so as a group, we work together to achieve our goal. So a goal will be common to everyone in a group. So teamwork means combined effort of a group. So this poet Jan Nigro says that we have to work together as a team. Okay, so we have to do a teamwork. Together we can make our dream work. So if we work together as a group, what we can able to achieve? Yes, we can able to achieve our dream. So everyone will be having a goal in their life. So if we work together as a team, we can able to achieve our dream. Then we'll share the joy of what we have done. Okay? Then we'll share the joy of what we have done. So after achieving a dream, how we will feel? Yes, we'll feel very happy and joyful. So what we have to do? We have to share the happiness with the others. Okay? We have to share the happiness with the others. So that's the meaning of the third one. So teamwork, everyone. So he is asking to make teamwork. Okay, everyone do the teamwork. So I'll repeat once again. Teamwork, teamwork. Together we can make our dream work. Then we share the joy of what we have done. Teamwork, everyone. Okay, that's the next stanza. It's fun to shoot the basketball through the hoop. It's fun to shoot the basketball through the hoop. So what is a hoop? Look at here. Hoop means iron ring. Okay, hoop means iron ring. So when playing basketball, how we play? We will pass the ball to one another, and at last we have to put the ball into the hoop. Okay, that means the iron ring. So if no one passes, it is possible to play the basketball? No, it's impossible. So that's what Rashmi said here. It's fun to shoot the basketball through the hoop. So it is very easy, okay? So it's very funful to put the ball into the basketball. So that means the hoop. But if nobody passes, then nobody shoots. So if no one passes the ball, can they able to put? No, we can't able to put. But the relay race just can't go on if nobody wants to pass the baton. And the relay race. So relay race means race between teams. Okay, relay race means race between teams. It's a game. Okay. So in relay race, what happens? Say the team members, any one of the team members will be having the baton. Okay. So baton means the short tube or stick. So it seems to be like a stick. Okay. But in the form of a tube or stick. So what happens? They have to pass the baton to one another. Okay? In the relay race, they have to pass the baton to one another. But if no one passes, nobody can be able to play the relay race. So, and the relay race just can't go on if nobody wants to pass the baton. So this is the meaning of the second stanza. I'll repeat it once again. It's fun to shoot the basketball in the hoop, but if nobody passes, then nobody shoots. And the relay race just can't go on if nobody wants to pass the baton. Okay. Now it is in the third stanza. We are the parts that make up the whole, and we have got our eyes on a common goal. Sometimes it can be a big plus when a you or a me becomes an us. I'll repeat this once again. We are the parts that make up the whole, and we have got our eyes on a common goal. Sometimes it can be a big plus when a you or me becomes an us. So what does it say the first line? We are the parts that make up the whole. So as a team, we are all working together. Okay, so we are all working together as a group, as a team, as a whole. And we have got our eyes on a common goal. So in our team, each and every person has a common goal. Okay, so we have a common goal. Sometimes it can be a big plus. Okay, well, what I've been saying here, sometimes it can be a big advantage when you or me becomes an us. So if we work together as a group, it becomes a big advantage to achieve our goal. Okay, so we are the parts that make up the whole, and we have got our eyes on a common goal. Sometimes it can be a big plus when a you or a me becomes an us. Have you understood this stanza? I'll repeat it once again. So as a team, you are all working together. So our aim is a common thing, and it would be a big advantage if you and me work together as a team. Okay? So I'll read the hard words. Teamwork, combined effort of group. Teamwork, combined effort of group. Who? Iron brain. Who? Iron ring. Passes, move onward. Passes, that means moving from one place to the other place. Relay race between teams. Relay race between teams. Baton, short you or stick. Baton, short you or stick. Okay, we'll read the poem from first. Teamwork. Together we can make our dream work. Then we'll share the joy of what we have done. Teamwork, everyone. It's fun to shoot the basketball through the hoop, but if nobody passes, then nobody shoots. And the relay race just can't go on if nobody wants to pass the baton. We are the parts that make up the whole, and we have got our eyes on a common goal. Sometimes it can be a big plus when a you or a me becomes an us. And this poem was written by Jack Negro. Hope you all understood this poem. Okay, students, so now we are going to see the book exercises that is given in page number 22. Name the team members needed for the following. Okay, name the team members needed for the following. So, this poem we have seen about the teamwork. Okay, so from that they have given exercises related to that. So to play cricket we need, okay, to play cricket we need. So you have seen or played cricket. So can we able to play alone? Is it possible? No, it's impossible. So we can't able to play alone. So we need some members with us. So who are all the members we need? Batsman, bowlers, fielders, coaches. Okay, so batsman, bowlers, fielders, coaches. So with these persons we can able to play the cricket. And the second one. To make a film we need. So who are the persons? Actors, directors, producers, with cameraman, and many persons are there. So to make a film we need actors, directors, producers. Okay, so I have given answer for the second one and the first one. So what you are going to do now, you are going to write the answer for the fourth and the fifth. Okay, sorry, the third and the fourth. So to run a good school we need, to run a restaurant we need, Okay, so you obviously know to run a good school for all the persons we need. Likewise, the persons that are needed to run a restaurant. Okay, have you understood? So to play cricket, we need batsmen, bowlers, fielders, coaches. To make a film, we need actors, directors, producers. Likewise, you have right the answer for to run a good school, to run a restaurant in page number 22. Okay, so in page number 23, they have given you the rhyming words. Okay, so you already know what is meant by rhyming words. So what is meant by rhyming words? Yes, words that ends with the same sound. Okay, the words that ends with the same sound, that is known as the rhyming words. Example: sun, bun, cat, rat, book, cook, sit, hit. So these words ends with the same sound. Okay, sun, bun, cat, rat, book, cook, sit, hit. So you all know this rhyming word. So you have to complete the exercise that is given in page number 23. So you will be having an activity related to this rhyming words at the end of your class. Okay. So next we are going to see is another poem. Okay, to be enjoyed. So poem. For what? For want of a name. Okay. The topic of the poem is for want of a name. So what is name here? In this poem, this name is nothing but it's not the name that is in your fingers. Okay. For example, if you want to hang the clock on the wall, so what you will do? You will hang it on the nail. Am I right? Can you guess what it is? Yes. So for want of a name. So for want of a name, the shoe was lost. For want of a shoe, the horse was lost. For want of a horse, the rider was lost. For want of a rider, the battle was lost. For want of a battle, the kingdom was lost. And all for the want of this shoe name. So look at the first sentence, first line. For want of a name, the shoe was lost. So on going in search of the name, what has been lost? Yes, the shoe was lost. So on searching for the name, the shoe has been lost. For want of a shoe, the horse was lost. So the shoe was lost. So what here has been done? To search. Okay, someone has been going to search the shoe. Okay, someone has been going to search the shoe. At the time, what has been lost? Yes, the horse was lost. And the third line: for want of a horse, the rider was lost. So the horse has been gone. Okay, the horse has been gone. So a rider went in search of the horse. So who has been lost here? The rider was lost. For want of a rider, the battle was lost. So for want of a rider, who was lost? The battle was lost. For want of a battle, the kingdom was lost. So kingdom is nothing but when the king has been ruling a place, that's known as a kingdom. Okay, so the king will be ruling. So for want of a battle, the kingdom was lost. And all for the want of the shoe name. So these has been lost only because of the shoe name. Okay, I'll repeat once again. For want of a name, the shoe was lost. For want of a shoe, the horse was lost. For want of the horse, the rider was lost. For want of a rider, the battle was lost. For want of a battle, the kingdom was lost. And all for the want of a shoe name. So from this poem, we have to frame questions for the given answers. Okay, so the answers will be given, we have to frame the questions. So let us read the answer first. The shoe was lost because of the name. Okay, the shoe was lost because of the name. So while framing questions, you have to start with a question word. Okay, like why, what, whom, which, where. You all know what is the question word. So the word which starts with double H letter are known as the question words. So we are going to start with why. Okay, why was the shoe lost? So was is the verb here. So next to the question word, we are adding the verb is. So the next one, lost. Okay, so lost is the main verb in the sentence. So lost. Sorry. Why was? So after the verb, we are writing the subject. Okay, so what is the subject in the sentence? the shoe. Okay, so why was the shoe? And what is the main verb here? Lost. Okay, so verb means it's nothing but the action. Okay, the main verb here. So main verb is lost. So at last we have to put the question mark. So why was the shoe lost? I'll repeat once again. To frame question, we have to start with WH word. Okay, so why? After question word, we have to write the auxiliary verb. So the auxiliary verb in the sentence is was. So why was? So next to the auxiliary verb, we have to write the subject. The subject is the shoe. And we have to write the main verb, lost. So why was the shoe lost? The shoe was lost because of the name. And the second one. Why was the kingdom lost? Why was the kingdom lost? Sorry, I'll read the answer first. The kingdom was lost because the battle could not be fought. The kingdom was lost because the battle could not be fought. So how to start? Yes, we have to start with the question word why. Why? Is there any auxiliary verb in the sentence? Yes, was. So why was? And what is the subject here? The kingdom. Okay. So why was the kingdom? And next to the subject, we have to write the main verb lost. Why was the kingdom lost? Have you understood the students? So you have to start with the question verb and you have to write the auxiliary verb, next to subject, and at last main verb to frame questions. So two I have done for you here. You have to complete the third one in your book. Okay, so in page number 23. Okay, students. So next we are going to see is contractions. So I'll read the definition. We sometimes use short forms for some words. So contractions is nothing but we have to write in the short form instead of the full form. Okay. So I apostrophe M for I am. I apostrophe V for I have. So these are all the short forms of these. I am, I have, I have. Okay. So this is for the contractions. These shortened words are contractions. The mar apostrophe, that means it is mar, is an apostrophe which shows where the letters are left out. So we are giving the letter A and here HA. Okay. So instead of that, we are using the apostrophe. So contractions are nothing but we sometimes use short forms for some words. For example, I am for I am, I have for I have. These shortened words are contractions. The mar is an apostrophe which shows where the letters are left out. So look at some of the examples. We will, we, you have, you are, cannot, can't, we are. Okay, so apostrophe. We have written apostrophe in a short form. So these are called as the contractions.
Okay, students, now let us learn the rhyming words. The first one is box, fox. Repeat after me. Box, fox. So these words ends with the same sound. Box, fox. Tub, rub. Tub, rub. Ball, all. Ball, all. Mat, hat. Mat, hat. Bun, gun. Bun, gun. So these are all the rhyming words. So rhyming words is nothing but the words which ends with the same sound is called as the rhyming words. Now let us read once again. Box, fox. Box, fox. Tub, rub. Tub, rub. Ball, all. Ball, all. Mat, hat. Mat, hat. Bun, gun. Bun, gun. Okay, now let us match the rhyming words. First, let us read those words. The first one is lake. L-A-K-E. Lake. F-A-T. Fat. P-I-N-E. Pine. T-I-N. Tin. Fine. F-I-N-E. Fine. I-N. In. T-A-K-E. Take. B-A-T. Bat. Shall we match the rhyming words? The first one is lake. So the rhyming word for lake is, guess what? Yes. Take. T-A-K-E. So lake, take. And the second one is fat. F-A-T. Fat. So what is the rhyming word for fat? Look at here. Yes. bat, B-A-T, bat. So, fat, bat. And the third one is pine, P-I-N-E, pine. Yes, the rhyming word for pine is fine, F-I-N-E. And the last one is tin, T-I-N, tin. And the rhyming word for tin is in. Shall we read it once again? Lake, take. Lake, take. Fat, bat. Fat, bat. Pine, fine. Pine, fine. Tin, in. Tin, in.
Okay students, and this is for your home assignment. Complete page 22, 23, 24, 27 in your English textbook. Okay, complete page number 22, 23, 24, 27 in your English textbook, and this is for your activity. Collect and paste some pictures about teamwork in your note. Okay, collect and paste some pictures about teamwork in your note. Hope you all enjoyed this class. See you in the next class. Thank you, everyone.